This video is for people who are trying to select and develop the proper reflow profile. It will tell you the differences between the three main profile types. We know that establishing a reflow profile is extremely critical. What can you tell us about the different types of profiles and where we might use them?
Well, there's three main profiles that we like to use. There's the ramp to peak, which is just a straight linear ramp from room temperature up to the peak temperature. This is the most commonly used. It does not hold the board or components at high temperatures for extended periods of time, so it's the most gentle on them. And with current fluxes, we find that it's the best in terms of voiding and other issues that might be seen resulting from the reflow phase. With the ramp soak spike, what it is it ramps up, it levels out below the liquidus point, and then it ramps back up to the peak temperature. And the reason for that is I like to use it when I've got a large board with a lot of mass or a lot of components of various sizes and types, and I need to equilibrate the temperatures across all of them before we get into the liquidus phase of the profile. So that's really the only place that I would use that profile. And then the shoulder profile, we ramp up, it levels off just slightly before the liquidus state and then goes up to peak. And what that does is it slows down the melting of the alloy a little bit, and it helps with issues such as tombstoning. So each profile kind of has its place where it's used.
So have you experienced a situation where profiling helps solve a problem or a defect?
Yes, actually just the other day I received a call from a customer. They were seeing graping on their board. And the first question I asked was, well, have you profiled? And while we were still talking on the phone, they were able to email me their profile. I was able to take a look at it, and I saw that it was a little bit long, actually about 2 minutes longer than what I would recommend. So they were just drying out the flux, and I recommended to increase the belt speed and bring that time down a little bit, and we were able to solve the problem.
Now, what about the opposite situation?
Yeah, I've also been called in to help customers, and I get there and all they've got is a board. They don't have any components, they're not going to be running any solder paste. So in order to profile that, I go in with my handy profiler here, and I attach the thermocouples to the board, and we run it through the oven a couple times and end up with a profile that appears to be good. But we really don't know at that point. So I kind of have to leave them for the day with the thought of, you know, once you start running this, if you experience problems, give me a call and let me know and we can tweak it from there. But I really can't solve anything at that point.
Derek, you have a very challenging job, no doubt about it. Where can we go for more information on profile shapes and selection?
We can be found at www.indium.com.
Thank you very much,
Derek. Thank you.